So this is kind of the downside of, can't even see what I'm doing. This is one of the downsides of this fixture, is that I have to remove both of these clamps, or loosen both of these clamps, just to take the pencil in and out. So when I'm installing this pencil fixture, I have three points that it goes into my T-rails. This point essentially is the one that holds it in place, because these two are constantly loosened and tightened for taking the pencils in and out. That's something we need to fix in a future version. The other thing that you have to do is make sure that this Y-axis lines up with the Y-axis of the machine. And the way I do that is I just put the tool down here at my zero line, and then I run it down about 100 to 120 millimeters and see if it's the same distance away from this leading edge. If it is, I'm good. If not, there's enough room where I can twist this just a little bit to get it lined up exactly how I need it. Once it's all lined up, I tighten this bolt down, and that holds the fixture in place. So these two clips, or these two bolts, are really not needed to hold the fixture in place. Again, something to fix in version 2. Here's the tricky part of getting this set up. Putting the pencil in is relatively easy. Just put the pencil in, make sure that it's pulled tight up against this edge, and then we clamp it down at both ends. Now the first pencil is going to need to have a little more work because we have to zero it. Now apparently my spindle's in the way of clamping this down. All right, so now we need to go back to our X of zero, and we need to bring our tool down. This is the tricky part, because it's so small, it's hard to see exactly where to get this set. That should be about our Y0 on the pencil. And our Z0 is also a tricky one, because we want to get that tool down just so that it's about ready to touch the pencil. Because the pencil is so small, it's kind of an awkward position. The Z probe doesn't work very well here, so it has to be done visually. Let me get my magnifying glass. All right, so what I do is, using the magnifying glass, I can see, if I push the right button, it would help. Anyway, I can see where that tool is, and I can bring it down just where it touches. And then I can set that as my Z0. Now all we need to do is run the program. Looks like that did a good job of cutting it. Might have been a little low on my Y setting, but that's fine. It turned out well. But I'm using a program called Desk Engrave, www.deskam.com is where I got this. It's a little free app. It allows you to do simple engraving of text. So I set my height at 2.7, and this is for millimeters, and I type in the text that I want it to do. There are some other parameters that I can set. If I go in here, I can set some parameters. So just real simple stuff, such as the depth of the cut, which is 0.2 millimeters, so it's a very shallow cut. And then I can set my movement height, speeds, and precision. This program then generates my G code, and I just take that right into my sender program. And for that, I am using Universal G-Code Sender. It's a Java app that does a really nice job. It has a preview window, so I can see what the cut's going to look like. And the basic controls for zeroing, homing, and that sort of stuff. So it's a nice little app. It runs well for our nice little machine. Once the pencil is done, it's a little hard to see what it says, so I'm going to take a crayon and fill that in with colored wax. Then we'll take a look at it. So, just taking a crayon and rubbing it across there brings out, it says CNC at home, brings that out nicely. This is just a dark blue, or just regular blue. Then just wipe off the excess with a Kleenex and it'll look great. All right, so we'll just wipe that off. There, and then we have our pencil, it says CNC at home. Now we've got room, as you can see on the pencil, for quite a bit more. There's about approximately 140 millimeters of workable area the way that this fixture is set up.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.